Okay, so this problem deals with an isothermal plug flow reactor of a reaction type, simple reaction type of A plus B goes to C that occurs in the gas phase, which is going to be important in this problem because we notice that we're going from 2 moles with the reactants to 1 mole of product. So we're going to have a decrease in the number of moles, and that's going to affect the volumetric flow rate as we go down the reactor and convert reactants to products. All right, we're given that the PFR has a volume of 100 liters and a volumetric flow rate of 25 liters per minute. All right, we're further told that this is an isothermal reaction, so the temperature is constant at 400 Kelvin, and the pressure is also constant, so we can ignore pressure drop at 2 bar. And we measure a conversion of 50%, and then want to know what this means for the reaction rate constant. All right, so first of all, we can express the reaction rate for consumption of A. We're told that this is an elementary irreversible reaction under the conditions of this experiment. So this is equal to K times CA times CB, first order in each reactant. And then furthermore, we see that there are equal molar amounts of A and B, so that makes things simple. And A and B are also in a one-to-one stoichiometry, so there will always be exactly as much A in the reactor as B. Concentration of A is always equal to concentration of B, so we can lump them into one concentration term and call it KCA squared. All right, we then would like, for simplicity's sake, to convert this CA, concentration of A, into a relationship that relates that concentration to the initial concentration times the function of conversion, as we've done in many other problem types now. Right, and so the concentration, if this were a liquid phase reaction of A, would be equal to CA naught times 1 minus X. So as you convert more X, you decrease the concentration of A, obviously. Right, but this is not just a liquid phase reaction, it's a vapor phase reaction. And what we have to bear in mind is that for each mole of A that we convert, we lose 1 mole of reaction mixture. What this means is that we, in Fogor's notation, we have this 1 plus epsilon x here, where epsilon denotes this change in number of moles, and the change, therefore, in the volumetric flow rate, so that's going to affect our concentration. And in this case, that value of epsilon is going to be, and since we lose half a mole, this will be 1 minus x over 2 squared. And so this is because for every mole of A we consume, we also consume a mole of reactants. And so we're decreasing the volumetric flow rate down the reactor, which tends to increase the concentration. And I'm not going to go into the details for how we get this epsilon is equal to the inlet mole fraction of A, which is 1/2, since it's an equal molar feed, right, times the stoichiometric coefficient C minus the stoichiometric coefficient of B minus the stoichiometric coefficient of A. All right, so for every mole of A that's consumed, we consume 1 mole net of reactants, right, times this mole fraction of 1/2. That gives us the negative 1/2. But the other way to just think about it is that the volumetric flow rate, if all of the A and B are consumed, right, then it will be cut in half because you'll have half as many moles total on the product side as you have on the reactant side. And therefore, what you expect is that as X goes to 1, the volumetric flow rate, which is really what this term is affecting, will be cut in half. And that's what we see happens. When X goes to 1, this goes to half. Okay, we won't go into the details of that derivation in this particular screencast. Okay, so this is how we can express the rate in terms of conversion. All right, we then want to plug that rate in order to solve this problem into a material balance. I'll use this integral form of the material balance, that V over FA naught is equal to the integral from 0 to our final conversion of 0.5. of dx over negative Ra. And so then we just need to plug in and actually do some integration here. And so if we substitute in this expression, then we get on this side the integral from 0 to 0.50 of 1 minus x over 2 squared dx over 1 minus x squared. And that's equal to v over fa naught. The rate, of course, has the k times ca naught squared terms. So I'll multiply both sides of the equation by those terms, and so that gives us a v times kca naught squared over fa naught. It's a collection of constants over here. And of course, what we want to solve for is our rate constant k. All right, this you can look up in a math book, or in this case, in the back of Fogler, the formula for solving this. But it's in an integral table, typical integral table. We evaluate that from 0 to x equals 0.5. All right, and the other things that we need to evaluate in order to solve for k, this will give us a number here on the right-hand side of our equation. We have everything we need to get a number in doing that evaluation of that integral. The volume is also given, so this is equal to 100 liters. And now we just need the concentration and molar flow rate. I'll do that on the next page. The molar flow rate, we can determine this is at 2 bar and a reasonable pressure. So we can determine this molar flow rate in terms of the ideal gas law. So it's equal to the mole fraction of A times the pressure times the volumetric flow rate over RT. Okay, and so we can solve for the molar flow rate of A entering the reactor, our FA naught value, as being equal to 0.7 full square minute. And then we can easily solve for the inlet concentration. That's just equal to FA naught over V naught. So the molar flow rate over the volumetric flow rate gives us our concentration. And we just solve for this one, 0.75 moles per minute over 25 liters per minute to get a concentration of 0.030 moles per liter. All right, and that is all that we need. We now have, I won't go through all the details of plugging in every number, but we now have that CA naught term, which we can square. We have the FA naught. We evaluate simply this integral between the limits of x equals 0.5 and x equals 0. I'm being sure to actually evaluate x equals 0 and not just leave it out. All right, and we're able to solve, and what I get for the value of k is 6.0, and collecting units, we get liters per mole minute associated with a typical second order reaction rate constant, for which you should get volume per moles time. And so in this problem, this is a pretty straightforward application of solving for a PFR volume, with maybe the only tricky part that you have to remember to take into account the fact that the volumetric flow rate is going to be changing down the length of the reactor. And recall that this part of our expression for relating concentration to conversion deals with the change in the number of moles with reaction, whereas this part deals with the change in the volumetric flow rate associated with reaction, which is directly related to the total number of moles in the reaction mixture, whereas this is just the number in the numerator is just the number of moles of A. So try to be sure to keep that straight as you solve these problems, that this deals with total moles and the numerator deals with the moles of A.